presentations are, but hopefully not any longer than 20 minutes. We're all falling asleep.
Nah.
So we'll kick off, and then so everyone will get a chance to present, and then our judges will have made sure that they get to come around and demo. We'll break for kind of 10 minutes, and then we'll come back together and let you know who our prize winners are and a bit of feedback as well. So, do you guys want to kick off?
Cool, yes, you can talk to Beck.
Yeah, right.
Hi everyone, we were the team that was kind of working over there at the back. And this is our little, we did the keynote or a slideshow. We came up with like a piece of paper that summarised the whole weekend for us. So we started with our problem, and we started with, in the industry, we know that we need people who can create and people who have that creative mindset. And the problem was that in schools, especially at primary schools, they're trying to introduce all this new technology, but they're not changing the mindset that they have, that they're teaching it in. And so we decided that they need to stop teaching them to know and start teaching them to learn. So it's all about being creative. And so we wanted our solution to have kind of an infinite creativity sort of thing, where you can be in this world, in this AR world, and it's up to you. You're provided with a set of tools, and you can manipulate the world. It's about you creating whatever you want. We were inspired by Minecraft. We were inspired by Lego, where there's not like a kit, like a set of instructions. It's all about you. It's all about what you can create. And it's really teaching kids, not teaching them to memorize, not teaching them all of that, but teaching them to create constantly, to adapt, because we thought you can learn, there's not one language that you're going to learn that's going to be relevant 5 years, 10 years from now. It's constantly changing. So it's that skill to be able to change and to be able to adapt that you should be teaching, not focusing on teaching like one language, because that's just going to go out of the window as soon as everything's created. So our progress, we started with this really cool idea, was that we'd have like an AR world or something, like a museum, and kids would go in and create all these little like pop-up games and little like show and tell things that they could share with all their friends in this world. And then from there we decided to make it more game related, had things that they could interact with, and then we realised we were thinking really big, so we brought it back and started thinking about what can we achieve this weekend. And it evolved into a puzzle-like game where one player could go in and leave a puzzle or like a treasure hunt for someone else. And yeah, this is what it's like. You go in and you can create all these different cubes. And we're using voice and sound as well, recognition.
Red cube. Yellow cube. Green cube. Red block. Perhaps if you remember the right word.
Yeah, so they create such a right, those blocks.
Green block. Green block. Okay.
Oh, I did go.
Cool. Play game.
Right.
So the aim of the game is to get rid of all these blocks, but you have to get them in the right order, but you have to guess that. So I've got a little buzzer telling me that red is not what I'm after. Green is what I'm after. Now, if I didn't know that green was up there and I was having trouble finding it, I can say, where's green? Now, using spatial sound, I can tell that it's somewhere up here. And click it. So, yeah, guess right there. Again, if I don't know where red is, I can go, where's red? Where's red?
That's the game over one. So yeah, that was our little game that we did, and it really proves to us that this is a concept that we can continue to take, and that it's something that we can do. And just being able to interact with the space and build all those blocks wherever you like, and doing that is the idea. So yeah, in the future we want to be able to have a bigger tool range, so not just creating the blocks, but maybe having levers, having things that like blow up when you get the block right, or being able to shoot balls at the blocks and stuff like that, something a bit more interactive. And yeah, we think this is a really good idea, the best idea ever, because it's really helping those kids at that level and changing the mindset of teaching, not just for technology and for going into computer science, but just in general, because that's the way everything's heading and that's the way that it should start at an elementary level. So that's what we've been working on. Yeah, hope you enjoyed it.